How's it going, guys? Andy here and welcome back to another video. Today I have a houseplant review and repot for you. This has actually been on my wish list for quite some time, so I'm pleased to have found it and to tick it off the list, so to speak. And today I've got Oxalis Triangularis to review and repot. This is a fantastic plant, isn't it? I just love the delicate leaves, the rich red colours, and actually I didn't think this was the variegated one. There, you get a few sort of ones with the plainer, just rich dark leaves, which are cool, but the ones I really like have the variegation and the lighter red within them as well. And yesterday, obviously, I transported it back from the houseplant shop and it just looked completely plain, but I've given it a water and it's had a bit of time to relax, and I can see the variegation in these leaves. You probably can't see it here on the video because it's only just coming through, but look at those flowers. Really delicate, beautiful little downward hanging flowers, and the leaves as well as the flowers are actually photophilic, which means they do all sorts of movements according to the light and any disturbance as well. They'll open up and at night they close up as well. So a really interesting plant to watch. And I just think they've just got such delicate little leaves, and I just think they're really interesting. So I'm pleased to get this. I know where I'm going to put it. So it's not one of those ones where I'm going to struggle to find a home for it. A great thing about buying new plants is you get to learn all about them. And this particular one has been quite interesting because it's quite counterintuitive. A lot of houseplants, they don't like getting cold. They can't get too much sun. And there's a lot of very specific requirements. This one is a breath of fresh air because it actually prefers to be a bit on the cooler side. It's quite happy with a lot of sunny conditions as well. So I've got a spot in my front porch that gets a lot of sun, but also, especially at this time of year, does get quite cold at night. And a lot of the houseplants I've got just wouldn't be happy there. They would struggle there. But this one actually prefers the cooler temperatures. If it gets above sort of 25 degrees Celsius, I don't know what that is, 80, I'm guessing, 80 Fahrenheit, something like that, is going to get a little bit stressed. So it will prefer the cooler conditions, which is great because it opens up new areas for people to keep their houseplants. And if you've got a cold spot in your house or a particular cooler place in a conservatory or a porch, then this is useful because you can have some really beautiful color in your living space and not worry about whether they can survive in the cooler spots. So yeah, this Oxalis is going to be in my front porch. And okay, I know I've said in previous videos that if you just buy a plant, there's no need to repot it straight away, and that's usually the case. They're usually happy in the pot for quite some time, and it's good to let it settle in as well. But I'm going to break my own advice and repot this one today. Firstly, because I know where this has come from. It's come out of the houseplant shop. It's been there for some time. We've had this whole lockdown malarkey, and this plant is not fresh in. It's been there for some time. It's kind of stabilized. It's okay, you know. So it's come from a known supplier. It's not come from a house. It's not come from a garden center where it might have just turned up yesterday or something. I know its provenance, so to speak, and I know it's been around a while. And so this one's okay, and they're also pretty robust, these plants as well. They're actually a clump forming type of plant. I don't know if you'll be able to see this, probably not, but they actually form, I'll give you a show to show you just in case, they actually form little clumps, and they actually grow from like corms or bulbs. So in terms of propagation, it's super easy. You're probably easier when I take it out of its pot and you'll see it better then. But you can actually just pull the clumps apart to make new plants. So really easy to get new plants. As they grow, you can just pull them apart. And I just love the contrast, you know, the really deep foliage contrasting with these really delicate little flowers. It's fantastic. Now, the other reason I want to repot it is because I've got the perfect pot for this one. I've had this pot that was given to me by my sister-in-law. Let me think. A good few months ago, probably 4 or 5 months ago, and I've been saving it for the right plant. It's a relatively small pot. It's like a clayey earthenware pot, and it's from South Africa. And I've been waiting to find the right pot. And this one, the contrast between these red leaves and this is like an earthy grey pot. And that is going to go in there perfectly. Now, it doesn't fit perfectly because this lip is just a bit bigger. So I don't think I'm just going to sit it in the pot. Let me have a think. Yeah, I might see. I'll either do two things. I'll either see if I can put it in a slightly smaller pot, which I think will be fine. I'll check when I get it out of the pot. Just take a little bit of the soil off and put it in a slightly smaller pot and then it'll fit right in. Or I'm just going to plant it directly in the pot. I think it will be fine in there because it's like an earthenware pot. They're quite good at taking the moisture away and going into the pot as well. So it shouldn't get too overwatered in here, especially if you just regulate the water a little bit more. But we'll figure that out as we go. Not 100% sure, but how awesome is this? Just take in how cool it is. Now, some of the leaves on here look a little bit battered. I'm not sure whether it just got jostled around when it was transported originally in, because they tend to be in big pallets of lots of plants. And so you can see there's some blotching and marking there. That might be just where the leaves have got crushed a little bit, but they're so prolific at putting on new leaves. There's loads of smaller leaves coming through. And so it won't be long before there will be plenty of fresh, new, dark leaves coming through. But what a lovely looking plant. I'm looking forward to looking at this every day when I leave the house and come back in again, especially with those little flowers. Beautiful. Right. So let's cover the care guide now before I forget. So light, I think we've already gone over that. A bright sunny spot's going to be fine for it, but it will take some partial shade as well. But they are quite happy in like higher levels of light as well. So wherever you've got should be all right, to be honest with you. As long as, I mean, you can even put this on a windowsill, as long as it's not getting scorching south-facing sun directly on it, which will probably knock it out a bit. But it will take a fairly bright spot, which is great because my porch can get a reasonable amount of sun. Watering, this is a difficult one because when I was researching this, I was getting conflicting opinions about it. A lot of people were saying it needs regular watering. Other people were saying it needs to not get overwatered and well, nothing really likes to get overwatered, but let it dry out a bit. And some people are watering them a couple of times a week. So I'm going to have to see for myself really how it reacts. But certainly my gut instinct is you should always let the plant dry out a little bit in between waterings. So when you do water it well, make sure you've thoroughly got the soil moist, and then give it some time, a good few days for the top inch or so to dry out, and then water it again. So regular watering at least once a week, maybe more if you live in a warmer place and it's getting a lot of light and the pot is getting dried out pretty quick. Maybe it might need a couple of times a week, but you'll have to suck it and see, and just check it on a daily basis to begin with and see how quickly the soil dries out. If it dries out quicker, you need to water it more. If it stays moist, don't water it, because that's when you're going to overwater it. So you just have to let the plant tell you what it needs, really. That's the best thing to do. But you're certainly going to hurt it more by overwatering than underwatering. If it dries out for a day or so, it's not really going to do it any harm. Then you can give it some water again, okay? And don't forget, even when the top inch or so of soil is dry, there's a good chance there's still going to be moisture further down in the pot. So all is not lost if it feels a bit dry. But if it's constantly wet and you don't give it time to totally dry out, then you could potentially have problems. Now, before we get this repotted, there's one really interesting point about this particular plant that I think a lot of people wouldn't know about and could really have an issue with. And that is, this plant can go into dormancy during winter periods. Not every winter, but some winters it will go into dormancy, which means all the foliage will die back and it will just sit there and do nothing. And most people, I'm sure, will assume it's just died and they've killed it. And they'll go, oh, well, that's a shame. And they'll throw it in the trash and that would be that. But these plants do go into dormancy, which means they're just going to sit there and chill out. They get to re-energize. Grr, fungus gnat. Don't go anywhere near that. That's why that Aspidistra is in here at the moment. It's caught some fungus gnats from somewhere, so it's being isolated in here so it doesn't transfer to my other crop. But anyway, I don't want it going anywhere near this one. Where was I? Yes, dormancy. So it goes into dormancy to revitalize its energy, and then when it grows back again, it'll have a new lease of life and new vigor. So if you do have one of these and the foliage dies back, don't throw it away, whatever you do, because it may just be going into dormancy for a little while. Give it some time. Stop the watering, importantly, because when it's in this stage, it's not taking on any more water, so you'll just be overwatering it, and then you probably will kill it if you keep watering it because it can't use it. It's a good tip with any plants, really. If they're not growing very much in the winter, if you're in Europe or a cold country that gets colder in the winter and there's no discernible growth on a plant, you really need to wind back that watering and just give it a lot less water, because if it's not actively growing, it's not really taking on a lot of water, which means that the compost is going to get wetter and wetter. And then especially in the winter when it's a bit cooler, you're going to have issues with plants getting damp, and that's when you're going to have potential fatalities on your hands. So just a good rule in general, if plants aren't growing that much, slack them back with the watering. Anyway, when this one's concerned, if it does go into dormancy, just stop watering, leave it to one side, keep an eye on it. If all the leaves have died back, you can chop off the leaves, because all the nutrients will go from the new leaves back into the corms, into the actual plant itself. And then when the new leaves come up, you can then start watering again. So just, if you think it's dead, just put it to one side and give it some time. Like I said, no water. And then when it's ready, when it's had its time of dormancy in a few months or so, it's going to come back again. So a really important thing to note with these plants, because you might think you've just killed it, but it's just having a rest. Okay, so I think we've gone over the main care guidelines with this. They should be fairly simple, really. The only thing you can do is probably overwater and give it too much heat. I think they're the only two things. So if you live in a really hot country or a really hot area of a country in the US, Texas or something like this, then you might struggle in the summer. Unless you've got a cooler place, then it might struggle. Oh, the other thing that I wanted to mention, if you're in Europe or in the UK, this will actually survive outside, so you can actually plant this out. It's not frost hardy, but for the rest of the time, you can plant this out and it'll grow outside as well, which is pretty cool. But anyway, that's all I wanted to say about the care. Let's get on to repotting this, and hopefully we'll be able to have a bit of a better look at the roots and how it can be propagated when we have a look at how it clumps. But let's get this in its new pot and we'll figure out if we're going to use an internal pot or pot it directly. Let's go. I've got some pots here. That one's going to be way too big, obviously. That one's going to fit actually really well, but get stuck now. That fits really nicely, but it's too small. It's smaller than this pot, so that's no good. This one I think is a good happy medium. It's slightly bigger than the pot it's in, and it actually fits down there a treat. So I think I'm going to use this one. The lip just goes around. The lip does stick out just a little bit over the top, but I think that looks quite neat and tidy. And the actual pot itself goes all the way down to about there. So there's just a little bit, maybe half an inch, maybe a centimetre and a half, just to enable a bit of drainage as well, which I always like with these sort of pots. So I think that will be the perfect happy medium. It's always good to keep hold of your old pots just for this sort of purpose. It's better for the environment to reuse your pots. And also, you never know when you just need something just the right size. And keeping mild pots has helped me out many times. So there we are. That's what I'm going to use for this one, I think. So let's get these two out of the way. And we'll have a look. We'll see if we can open this up and have a look at it and see what it looks like. Now, obviously, these little branches are really delicate. So we've got to be really careful with this or else we're going to damage the individual parts of it. So really, I'm just going to suck it and see and just feel, oh yeah, it's nice and loose in the pot, which is very useful. There we go, gently does it. Okay, so let's have a look here. Now, can you see that? Don't know how good that is to see, but you might have a better idea of how it's clump forming. You see there's a clump there. There's three clumps in this pot. That's probably how the grower has put it. And you can see the corm there, and the inch individual branches grow out from the base. So you could, if you wanted to, split this up into three individual plants and then grow them on from there. I like this size. I think I'm going to keep it like this until it grows bigger. And then maybe when I repot it again, I'll divide it and take a bit of extra cuttings from it. But yeah, there's actually a new flower stem coming through there as well. It's pretty cool. Right, let's see how it fits in this pot. It's just a pretty much bang on, really, actually. I don't even think I'm going to need to put any more. I might just put what's come out back in. To be honest, it's probably all it needs. Take a few of the big bits out. Actually fits really nicely. It's a delicate plant, so just take your time and be careful with it. You don't want to damage any bits on it. I think that'll be all right, you know. And the good thing about that is it won't really have disturbed the roots too much. So we've literally just slipped it out of one pot, put it in another one, and that way it won't be too disturbed. So that will just slip into there. And also, because the lip of that pot is black and the actual foliage is black, you hardly see it. Yes, happy with that. What are we saying? That looks excellent. There's just a little motif of a protea there on the pot, which is the national plant of South Africa. So thank you, Seema, for my gift of this pot. It's been well used and I'm very pleased to have finally found the perfect plant for this pot. And that looks really good in there. I love the contrast of like the grey, slate grey colour and that amazing contrast of the leaves. Yes, very happy with that. What are you saying, YouTube? I think that is a lovely looking houseplant. For those of you that have been following the exploits of Mr. Mouse down in the comments, I think I found his front door. There we are, Iceman. There is living proof that Mr. Mouse exists in Andy's potting shed. If you haven't seen Iceman's comments below my videos, it's worth taking the time to go and hang out there because they're very creative and they always make me smile every time I read them. So thanks, Iceman, for your continued support and the interesting exploits of Mr. Mouse. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you found that useful or interesting. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. It really does make a difference to the whole YouTube algorithm thing. And subscribe if you're new around here as well, because I'm putting out houseplant videos every single week, and it would be great to see you here again. All right, guys, thanks again, and I'll catch you again soon. Bye for now.